abuses of the rules of natural justice. What, in your opinion, sir, do you consider the details of the coup?
My lord, I don't have to be repeating so
badly. Okay, okay, let me
but,
take you.
Okay,
take
no, 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 since you have asked the question, if you say details, the details are that on the 14th of February, officially, I now know that Bamayi was not arrested. I now know that Bashiru Magashi, the GOC of 2 Mechanized Division Ibadan, was not arrested.
Yes.
I now know that Brigadier Sabo, the Director of Military Intelligence, was not arrested.
Yes.
And I know that the Chief of Defense Intelligence, ABM Idi Musa, was not arrested.
Yes.
I now know that the commander of the battalion in Abuja,
yes,
was not arrested.
Yes.
I now know that all these people were not arrested.
Yes.
How can somebody feel, you put yourself in my position,
yes,
and these are,
yes,
people,
sir,
who came to me and passed through my house and said they were going to present a 4-point demand to Abacha, and
yes,
I gave them all the support.
Yes, sir. Sir, you have a very big shoe size. I can't step into your shoes. Sir, I'll be correct to say that one of the details of the coup is that the allegation that you discussed coup with General Aziza. Am I correct, sir?
I have also explained that was the beginning of the conspiracy.
I say, sir,
General Aziza alleged, they now brought him because they are now looking for a case. General Aziza was now brought to the tribunal to come and say that I discussed coup with him. Where? He said inside the car.
Yes, sir.
When? When I was going back to Abuja. Simple.
That was one of the allegations against you, sir.
Yes, that was the beginning. That was the allegation that I planned the coup. Let them give any other evidence that is outside Bamayi.
And secondly, sir, you were alleged to have funded the coup by providing $60,000, sir. Am I correct?
That was another allegation which I denied vehemently.
Very well, sir. And it is also one of the allegations that you vetted the coup speech.
That is another ploy, my lord.
Is it one of the allegations?
Aziza and Bamayi sat in Lagos. Nobody asked, they never discussed any coup speech with me. Nobody asked them to go and prepare any coup speech. They went to Lagos, Bamayi sat, presided over a meeting, attended by Aziza, attended by Olanrewaju, attended by late Akiyode, the poor boy who was trapped into the whole thing, and they said they were putting 4-point demand together. They are saying that if they go there and Abacha does not agree, what are they going to do? These are their own imaginations, their own formulations. Nobody sent them. And by the time they now finished, they now started sending different type of speech everywhere. What they sent to me was sent, luckily, through Major Akali. And if they now say what they sent to me through Major Akali is a coup speech, why was Major Akali himself not tried?
General, sir, my simple question is this. One of the allegations against you is that you vetted a coup speech.
I did not vet any coup speech. That's what I'm saying. What was sent to me was not coup speech.
Was it an allegation against you, sir?
It was an allegation, yes.
Very well.
It was an allegation.
Yes, sir. You admit in your petition that these details, by yourself, that these details are contestable. That means you are not sure too whether they are correct or not correct.
Look, the simple English I've used are contestable in the sense, if you ask them today, they are still denying. They are still denying. Is that not contestable?
You are also not sure whether you funded the coup or not.
How will I not know whether I funded? When it comes to evidence, you come and bring it out and say I funded coup.
I am going by what you stated yourself.
I did not fund any coup.
You are not sure also that you funded the coup.
I did not fund any coup, and there was no coup anywhere.
The fact that, sir, you vetted the coup speech is contestable.
I never vetted any coup speech, even the one that was tendered in the court. They were so ashamed they cannot read it out because it was Jeremiah Gashi's name that was there.
The fact that
even the one they tendered in court, they could not read the speech out, the so-called speech. If it was my speech, then it should have been I, General Adiko Dia. That speech, let them bring it out. The content is I, General Bashiru Magashi, the one they were forging and circulating in the name of his school speech.
You granted an interview to Tell Magazine on 4th October 1999. Am I correct, sir?
I've granted many interviews. I granted the interview to Tell, yes.
And my lord, sir, that is tendered as an exhibit. Can I have the Tell Magazine of 4th October 1999?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Please take a look at exhibit 9. Can you feel through to 18, sir? On page 18, sir, on the second column. Yes, sir, you were asked this question. When Bamoyi and company came to present the demands, and when they said if Abacha did not budge, they would remove him, you agree with me, with them. In the military, this is a coup. So why are you talking about the setup? And this was your answer, sir. If really Bamoyi and his group were actually acting with sincerity of purpose, I would agree it was a coup. Up to that point, it could have been a coup plan. I believed in what they were doing, and I gave them the support. But it was not a coup per se. I believed that if Abacha had seen all the security agents and the service chiefs, he would have budged and agreed to the 4 points. Sir, I will be correct to say that up to the point that the 4-point demands were brought to you, it was a coup plan by...
Look, by I have told you, sir. Okay, it's not... where is the coup in this thing? I am saying that this is an arrangement. A coup committee has been formed, unknown to me.
Exactly.
No. If don't quote, this out of context.
I'm sorry, sir. Is this what you told the Tell Magazine journalist that interviewed you?
What is here? I think is correct. Yes.
It's correct. Mm-hmm. Yes, because you also stated, sir, that at the time Bamoyi came to you, you could have reported him. You said so.
Look, when Bamayi came to me.
Did you say so, sir, in your interview?
I didn't say so.
You did not say
I could have reported him in what sense? If I didn't agree with what he's saying?
Yes, sir, I would take you to it. At the point Bamayi came to me, I had a choice to report him.
Exactly.
But I was not convinced that I should report anybody who was talking about Abacha. If I had reported him, they would have said I was a traitor. If I did not, it would still be the same thing. For the purpose of emphasis, maybe I should mention that this type of thing had happened before. That is your speech, sir. That is your interview.
I'm not opting out of the interview.
Yes,
I agree with what I said.
Yes.
And even on other occasions, I've even said that it was God that was actually directing me. Because if I reported that thing at that time, that saying that they were coming to him, they were coming to meet him with 4-point demand, whatever it is, you know, not knowing that the whole thing was a farce, they would have killed me.
Okay.
Because Abacha would have told them that, General D had come, he had reported you. They will now come to, because the objective was to kill, simple. They will have just come to say, eh, Oga, so after confiding in you and telling you that we are going to present this 4-point demand, you have betrayed us. They will just shoot me and they will put up a story as usual.
Very well. If you had reported General Bamayi and others that came to you, would you have been said to have reported a coup?
Look, I've told you, my lord, that request they brought to me.
Would
to
you
me,
have been said to have been reporting a coup at that time?
It wouldn't have been a coup. It wouldn't have been a coup, but the issue there is that if I reported, I don't know how they would have taken it. And in any case, I was not even in the frame of mind to report because I believed in everything they were telling me anyway.
It is correct, therefore, to say that at that point you were not loyal to your commander-in-chief.
Well, if you say so, I'm not going to argue that.
Well,
and loyalty is different from coup.
Sir, if you see your photograph, will you be able to identify it, I guess?
Photograph, yeah.
See yourself.
Yeah, of course.
Please take a look at this. No, let him look at this.
It's not us, sir.
That is you, sir.
Yeah, it's me, I think.
My lord, sir, I seek to tender the national interest of September 17th, 2000.
What is the last English?
Please quickly mark the exhibit and give it to me. September 17, 2000. General, sir.
Yes.
In answer to a question put to you by the journalist, who was supposed to be the coup announcer? You answer, certainly not me. Magashi was.
Good.
Is that correct?
No, it's that statement.
That statement as reported by national interest.
What did he say?
Did you say so?
That what?
In answer to the question, who was supposed to be the coup announcer? You said, certainly not me, Magashi was.
Good.
You said so.
I said so.
Very well, sir.
What? Well, let
sir,
me, let me expatiate.
Wait, just one moment. I think you witness or the chairman to be able to explain what you say you want to say. My senior can re-examine, sir. My senior can re-examine. Yes, sir. You were also asked this question. As the most senior officer, I suppose you were to be the head of state. You said, again, not me. Bamayi was to be head of state. It was Bamayi and Abacha's show. The person who stages the coup becomes head of state. It was Bamayi's coup. The only thing I was begging them for was that, please, they should not kill anybody. So you were aware of Bamayi's coup.
That is quotation out of context. I never said that.
You were not aware of Bamayi's coup?
Look, the Bamayi's coup thing came during the trial. And that is the beginning of the three. Look, let me tell you. That is nothing like lying lips. Your client is the man. My Lord, Bamayi wore three faces throughout this episode, and I made it clear, and I gave so many press conferences on it. He wore three faces, and that was the beginning of his problem between him and even his cohort now, Mustafa. A lot of publications will be brought and tendered where Mustafa himself said that Bamayi was planning a coup unknown to Dia. The issue now, sir, is that when Bamayi was not brought before the tribunal, the first time in the history of Nigerian Army that a chief of army staff was being brought to an SIT and an SMT, the first time, it was very clear that Bamayi was wearing three faces. One face to Abacha, giving him the impression that he was really roping me into a problem. Another face to me, giving me the impression that what he's presenting to me is genuine. And the third face to himself, Bamayi was planning the coup. And everybody now knew he was planning the coup. And that is the truth. When it gets to that, we will expatiate.
Okay, sir. Would I be correct, sir, to say that because of the inconsistent disposition of Bamayi, your disloyalty was made manifest?
I have told you, I never knew Bamayi was planning a coup until the coup speech, the so-called coup speech, was found with him, and Bashir Magashi was to read that speech. Until it was discovered that all the people that he recruited into the planning committee for Abacha, he recruited them. Because a vital question was asked him, why didn't you recruit General, the GOC of Ondiv, General Mukhtar? Kaduna is very near to Abuja. Why did you recruit the GOC at Ibadan? And you didn't recruit the GOC at Abuja, at Kaduna. Why did you recruit Lieutenant Colonel into your committee, into your planning committee, and you didn't recruit the brigade commander? The Lieutenant Colonel was serving under the brigade commander. That was where the whole thing started being blown open. And everybody now knew that Bamayi was planning a coup. He wore three faces and three faces throughout that period.
Which brought out your disloyalty.
To who?
Now, to the CEC, of course.
Anyway, I've never talked of loyalty. If 4-point demands are the things they really presented to the CEC, I have no regrets up to today.
Very well, sir. You stated that you met with Abacha after your arrest. You stated so before this commission.
I did.
At your meeting with General Abacha, you told him that the only senior officers you mentioned the coup to were Adisa, Olariowaju, and the garrison commander. Am I correct?
No, please.
At your meeting also, contrary to what you told this honorable commission, you did not go there to plead on behalf of Generals Magashi, the DMI, Aziza, and Bamayi, who you now told falsely that they were arrested. You did not plead before Abacha.
I have been very consistent on this.
Did you?
I pleaded for all of them. I pleaded that they should be released.
Yes.
And hold me responsible. That was my plea.
That is what you stated there, sir.
Yes.
Very well. You also told Abacha that you were so ashamed of yourself. Did you say so to him?
God forbid.
You did not say so.
I did not say so.
You knelt down before General Abacha to beg him because of your involvement in the coup. Did you or did you not?
That was impossible. That's your own machination and invention.
You wept before General Abacha and he had to give you tissue paper to wipe your tears.
That is your own machination and invention.
I'm sure that if you see General Abacha now, you can recognize him.
Not that person.
If General Abacha comes out before you to cross-examine you, can you recognize him? I will hit the car and he comes out, can you recognize him?
I hope you are trying to scare the public.
Please, sir, answer my question. With all seriousness, sir, if General Abacha should appear before you,
my
would
Lord,
you be able to recognize?
My Lord, dead men don't rise. Okay? So that's the way I will answer the question.
All right. seek to tender the videotape of the meeting. The videotape of the meeting between General Abacha.
To come and bring us something to play. The one they tendered can be played.
Yes, I
we went to three places.
I came very prepared. I have a video machine there and a 21-inch.
You brought a video machine
and a 21-inch color television.
You brought one.
And I will be urging the indulgence of this court, this commission, to play this exhibit. Is it a ticket? Mark it and.
Is this all edited?
My lord,
it will be edited. And if it is not edited, let them play it. If you are sure it is not edited, but I'm sure it will be edited.
I thought you said unedited.
Well, sir, the witness has.
What did you say? I'm not talking about the witness. I want to record what you said. Want to play a tape? What?
I want to play the tape of the meeting between General Dia and General Abacha after he was arrested for the coup.
I see.
To show to this commission what transpired between them.
What a detail. You see, because they will have removed Bamayi's name, everything, at the meeting. Yes, because they will have removed the names. Because there I was saying, Bamayi, why didn't you tell me? Why didn't
I'm seriously objecting. And this having been in possession of Bamayi, anything could have happened. Two, I am also saying that pictures these days have been shown to tell a lot of lies. You can doctor it, you can remove, you can add. Therefore, it's not credible.
In re-examination is to prove that there were something was added, something was subtracted. And then this is not a court of law, strict sensu. And this is a second fight, isn't it? Anything goes. I've been admitting all sorts of things which no judge could admit in a court. So let them admit it for what it's worth.
Yes, Lord.
My Lord, I don't know if I can borrow from the words of Chief Garifa, I mean, that the...
I thought you want to play something. What has Garifa got to do with this?
I mean, the face of the telly should be allowed for the public to look at something.
You don't want us to see it?
My Lord, sir, it is important one for the witness to look at it because I want to...
Is it important for us to also look at it?
My Lord is going to have it after the ceremony.
Suppose we doctor it.
Who, sir?
My Lord. Why not, sir?
My Lord will never do that.
I don't mean my Lord, I want about seven of us here.
None of you there will ever do that.
Every evidence is tendered to the commission. Therefore, this is evidence, it should be facing the commission. When we finish, then we can invite them. I hope we have another copy of the tape. Invite them somewhere and play for them. But everything should be facing the commission. Or if you can get a place where all of us be looking the same way.
My Lord, we can play. My Lord, sorry, sir. If maybe we need to play it twice. One for the witness to look at it, and then for the commission to also look at it. Then we can proceed. With respect, sir.
You see, I just complain. It will even strengthen our argument because it shows that they have already pronounced one guilty before. And they won't come at Dr. Eli. Because they will show the discussion between me and... We won't change dresses. Why did they withdraw it from the public? Yes.
What the editor?
I'm going to go to the hospital. We can't see it.
Turn it to the Lord. What is Lord? Is it there for you?
You are not. Do
you feel it? Yes. You said you are.
No boy.
Thank you.
money.
I believe there's no money. Not very bad.
The voice.
The voice.
It's not like that.
The voice. The problem.
When they finish now.
Council.
No,
what is the question?
No, they said that.
Don't lie, eh?
And what does it mean? If we hear what he's saying, when he was kneeling down, he threw something. What did he say when he did that? I don't know. We have a note in Liberty Report. He said so that when they talk about the 4-point program,
Show me, kill or wrong in Willie, where you have arrested the senior officers and you are pleading because you only. Oh, well, Jack, they want ND to reach in Ben. They
were asking,
they are replaying it again. You see, and they said they didn't edit it. Replaying the whole thing. All right, let it go. You should set up.
General.
They are replaying it again. You see, and they said they didn't edit it. Replaying the whole thing. All right, let it go. You should set up.
General, I want to ask you.
Speak louder.
I want to ask you once again, sir. Do you still stand
how to lie
by your
pictures? We have to lie with pictures, say much.
Do you still stand by your evidence that when you met with General Abacha after your arrest on the coup, you did not kneel down before General Abacha? Do you still stand by it?
I did not kneel down before General Abacha.
Yes.
I pleaded with him. That is the word. I pleaded with him to release all these generals who have been arrested. And until January 8th, when Franco Menka now told me that I'm being deceived, no general was arrested. It's only me and my Yoruba officers who were arrested. Simple.
Now, do you still stand by your evidence?
I stand by my evidence, and what you have shown, and what you have shown, it does not contradict my evidence.
That you did not cry before General Abacha.
If I did not cry before General Abacha, yes.
You are also standing by your evidence that General Abacha did not give you tissue papers to wipe your tears.
Look, if you know, why would they do withdraw the film from the public? When you even told the country you are going to play it on NTA. This film you have shown does not show anything. You play this to the public now and say what you are saying now.
If it should make... Carries,
No.
I was not a member of
a PM. I am telling you that even your edited film now, as it is edited, does not even show anything.
Okay. We'll leave it to the public.
Exactly.
In 1976, where were you?
1976, I can't remember. That was a very long time.
You were in the Nigerian Army, I want to suppose.
Yes, I must have been. I was a lieutenant colonel then, I think. Yeah.
Yes. You were aware that there was a coup in 1976?
I've told you, 1976 was a long time. Yeah.
There was a coup involving Dimka.
Yes.
1976.
Exactly.
Dimka and others were found guilty and convicted of staging a coup.
Yes.
They were all executed.
Yes.
You will agree with me that that execution was the implementation of the full weight of law.
Of course, sure.
In 1985, there was a coup plot.
85? Mention which coup? 85. Yes.
The same law under which Dimka and others were tried was the same law under which Basa was tried. Am I correct, sir? You were in the army then.
My lord, we are talking of real coups. You have already... No, let me talk. You are talking of coups. We are talking of an arranged coup. We are talking of a phantom coup. We are talking of a deception. We are talking of senior officers putting themselves into a coup planning committee at the highest level. They are different things.
Basa and others were tried under the same law that Dimka and others were tried.
Because they planned a coup, a real coup, not a phantom, not an arranged coup.
They were tried under the same law.
The same law that for coup plotters.
Yes. Basa and others were also found guilty and convicted for coup.
My friend, you know very well, if this was a coup, why was Bamayi not tried? Bashiru Magashi not tried? Why were all these people not tried?
Yes,
we are talking of a coup and an arranged coup. They are two different things.
Yes, sir, you are just being preemptive.
I'm trying to explain to you. I'm trying to let you know.
Sir, I'm not talking about the 1997 coup.
Okay.
You would agree with me that the execution of Basa and others was in full implementation of the weight of law under which they were tried.
Sure, yes.
Mm-hmm. In 1990, sir, there was a coup.
Which one is that?
The Oka's coup.
Mm-hmm.
Oka and others were tried.
Yeah,
it was a coup. They were found guilty.
Yeah, it was a coup, not an arranged coup.
They were executed, sir.
Yes.
It was an implementation of... In 1985, there was a coup plot.
85? Mention which coup?
Babasa's coup.
Yes, yes.
The same law under which Dinka and others were tried, this was the same law under which Basa was tried. Am I correct, sir? You were in the army then.
My lord, we are talking of real coups. You have already, no, let me talk. You are talking of coups. We are talking of an arranged coup. We are talking of a phantom coup. We are talking of a deception. We are talking of senior officers putting themselves into a coup planning committee at the highest level. They are different things.
Basa and others were tried under the same law that Dinka and others were tried.
Because they planned a coup, a real coup, not a phantom, not an arranged coup.
They were tried under the same law.
The same law that for coup plotters.
Yes. Basa and others were also found guilty and convicted for coup.
My friend, you know very well, if this was a coup, why was Bamayi not tried? Why was Bashiru Magashi not tried? Why were all these people not tried? We are talking of a coup and an arranged coup. They are two different things.
Yes, sir, you are just being preemptive.
I'm trying to let you know.
Sir, I'm not talking about the 1997 coup.
Okay.
I said, you would agree with me that the execution of Basa and others was in full implementation of the weight of law under which they were tried.
Sure, yes.
Mm-hmm. In 1990, sir, there was a coup.
Which one is that?
The Oka's coup.
Mm-hmm.
Oka and others were tried.
Yeah.
They were found guilty.
Yeah, it was a coup, not an arranged coup.
They were executed, sir.
Yes.
It was an implementation of the full weight of that law.
Yes.
In 1995, El Adwa and General Obasanjo, the president, were found guilty and convicted of a coup. Am I correct?
Partially correct, but now I have already expressed an opinion that was a phantom coup.
You are a lawyer, sir.
Yes.
They were found guilty and convicted of a coup.
Okay, let's make progress. Yes.
Yes. In 1997, you and others were found guilty and convicted of a coup.
Of an arranged coup. Yes.
You were found guilty and convicted.
Arranged coup, yes.
Yes. Now, do you know who signed that law under which you were tried?
I don't know.
Do you know under whose regime Dinka and others were tried?
That was in 1970. That was Jerome Basojo's regime.
Do you know if he was the one that promulgated the decree under which Dinka was tried?
Am I arguing against the law? I'm not arguing against the law. The law is there, but the law is for coup plotters. I am saying the law is not for coup arrangee. The law does not provide for people to arrange coup and start looking for people to implicate.
I know, sir. I agree with you that there is no provision for arranging.
Yes.
But the question that I am asking you, sir, with due respect,
thank you,
is that do you know if it was General Olusegun Obasanjo who promulgated that decree under which Dinka and others were tried?
I know.
Yes. He is from the Yoruba ethnic group.
Oh, that is not relevant. No? It's not relevant, my lord.
General Obasanjo is from the same Ogun state that you also come from.
Yes.
The 1976 coup, was it targeted at people who were then called Lantern Mafia or the Middle Belters?
Was it a coup or an arranged coup?
You see, sir, I allowed you to form your own opinion about 1997 coup. You said it was a phantom coup. I don't have any problem with that.
Okay.
You testified before this commission. Evidence, I mean, led. It is for the commission and the public to make up their own conclusion. I don't have any problem. You can call it phantom, a farce, a hoax, whatever. I don't know. That's not what I'm saying. But was it targeted at officers from Plateau and the Middle Belt, the 1976 coup?
No.
It was not.
Good.
Yes. What was your relationship with Fadipe?
I've said it. Fadipe is my security officer.
Now, was there any relationship between Akiode and Olariwaju?
Akiode served Olariwaju as his staff officer, and
was it you who told General Ati?
I gave so many press conferences on it. He wore three faces, and that was the beginning of his problem.
The coup by 4 point demand.
I was the one who told Adisa about the demand brought to me by Bamayi, and between him and even his cohort now, Mustafa, if really Bamayi was speaking the truth. That is quotation out of context. He reported back to me that even though Bamayi is saying, but because of the involvement of Brigadier Sabu, whom he believes is a very straightforward and good officer, he believes that yes, they were going to present the
to the know that General Adisa said that you and others were in a meeting on the 4th. Prior to what you told this honorable commission, you did not go there to plead on behalf of Generals Magashi, the DMI, Aziza, and Bamayi, who you now told falsely that they were arrested. You did not plead before Abacha.
I have been very consistent on this.
Did you not plead?
I pleaded for all of them. I pleaded that they should be released and hold me responsible. That was my plea.
That is what you stated there, sir.
Yes.
Very well. You also told Abacha that you were so ashamed of yourself.
The four-point demand.
Did you say so to him?
God forbid. But he came and I allowed him.
You did not say so.
I did not say so.
You knelt down before General Abacha to beg him because of your involvement in the coup. Did you or did you not?
That was impossible. That's your own machination and invention.
You wept before General Abacha and he had to give you tissue paper to wipe your tears.
That is your own. Very unfortunate.
Generals don't cry.
Jesus himself wept. If you don't know. Bashiru Magashi, the one they were. Abuja was not arrested.
Before this trial.
If he said so to you privately, that's your problem. In any case, I am not bound. Well, I think everybody knew he was sick.
Well, that is why I said we are taking God for granted. God is our witness. You told this honorable commission that you decided to stay put to pray for a divine intervention.
What? Who said divine intervention that you... No, if you are saying directly that maybe you have seen a fortune teller to say that you will die. nation and invention.
I'm sure that if you see General Abacha now, you can recognize him.
Until the coup speech, the so-called coup speech was found with him, and Bashir Magashi was to lead that speech. Until it was discovered that all the people that he recruited into the planning committee for Abacha, he recruited them. Because he got to an SIT and an SMT the first time. And that is the end of it. That is divine intervention. Because that was what I was waiting for, really. What I couldn't do was to resign, yes. Because to resign, I know what it means.
You said there is no
When, after they have discussed, General Bamina asked General Diaz, said, Oga, since you have, we have fixed this thing now, I think we need more money.